Self-driving vehicles rule the road at the American Center for Mobility in Ypsilanti, Michigan, but it's not a scene from a sci-fi movie. Previously known as Willow Run, the B-24 Liberator airplane factory helped Americans win World War II. Now lets clients test out driverless vehicle capabilities in a variety of urban settings.
75% of all automotive research happens here in Southeast Michigan, so this is really the place to be. Our customers can come out here and use this facility to work on their vehicles and do all their test planning before they go out onto the facility out in the open air.
The neglected General Motors property acquired in bankruptcy proceedings became a reminder of how interconnected business and the local community are.
There's always, I think, a psychological burden to a community of abandoned, blighted properties that aren't producing anything, particularly when the site used to have over 35,000 employees.
Imagine this. The community was getting taxes from General Motors at 25 or 30% of their overall budget. Utilities that were getting 10% of their budgets, and that disappears overnight.
We want to bring jobs back to the communities hurt by the bankruptcy. We want to bring new tax revenue back to those communities and work with the communities to return their sense of pride to the property. The impact in Michigan was substantial. Completing the cleanup and seeing a successful redevelopment, that supports the future of the state of Michigan and this country. And the American Center for Mobility is one of our landmark projects meeting all of those objectives.
The township and the local residents appreciate us converting this into a usable facility. We think it really has some opportunity to spur economic development in the entire region.
Working with the government can often make prospective buyers nervous.
So this is a very unique project that had local, state, and federal interest in the property, and each of the requirements and the bureaucracy from each of those really could have proposed a really significant challenge.
The EPA brought to the table to overcome and make redevelopment work is a process called the Prospective Purchaser Agreement. Prospective Purchaser Agreement is an opportunity for a buyer to limit their liabilities for future for any contamination that's a residual left at the site.
We're testing 3-4 days a week. We've got 8 individual test environments that are available for rental, and we're entertaining new customers and new investors every day.